Hi everyone, I'm Grahtles, and welcome back to another episode of Asset Editor. Today we're going to go ahead and jump into buildings. So let's go to Asset Editor and click New, and theme doesn't matter. So once it loads, you'll get a page like this, and we did intersection and we did park. So now we're up to buildings. So we're just going to click on buildings and continue. So we're going to get a template from up here, and I do have mods installed, so you will see other things other than vanilla. So you can ignore that. It doesn't matter too much. So anyway, we have a choice of basically manipulating any of these assets. So you can go to your police, your fire, you can go to low density, high density, industrial, commercial, residential. You could even do unique buildings, farming, all these different things. I think today, why don't we stick with something kind of simple, and we'll do a fire department, and I think we'll do the firehouse. We could either do this one or this one. It doesn't really matter. I guess we'll pick this nice little brick one. So once you get here, you could just click continue. And then once it loads, you get this panel right here. Now, the only thing we're going to change here is the size. So I think maybe we'll do like a 6 by 6, something like that. It says you can, I think, move it to expand the front yard, but that's usually with residential. It never really works with this. I don't know why. We're not going to change the color. I don't mind the brick. It's fine. And I think the color only changes the white. It doesn't change the brick. You could get sub meshes from steam, and that would change all that. But, you know, other than that, you don't need it. We can make it larger. We could do an 8x8 with parking lots maybe, and you could add things to the different, you know, the top of the building. But let's go ahead and take a look. So we can make this all concrete like this, or you can leave some green spaces maybe in the back here if you want. But for now, let's leave it the concrete. We can do some parking so they can park when they get here for a fire. So let me type in parking. And then once I do that, if I scroll down to here, I have some bike racks, which we could use right maybe in the front here. We can just put one there. That looks pretty good. And then we'll put in some parking maybe on the side here. Let's just, we could even come in a little bit and maybe make some green space or a walking path. So maybe that's what we'll do there. So we got some parking there. Let's go over to here, and I think we'll take this off and we'll add a path. Now you could do a bike path. You could do a regular path. You could just do a path like that. You can come across, so it'll attach, and it looks almost like a curb. Let me show you. So if we did paint this back, you can get a nice like path look, which is kind of cool. I think we'll leave it like that. You could even use the grass for instead of the concrete, but I like it like that. I think that looks pretty good. We can make a path around the front as well. So if we went to here and we just wanted to do like a concrete path and attach it there, you can do that. I think maybe we may keep this as concrete, but use the path here. So we'll do a path all the way around, and this way you can connect a path anywhere from your fire station. We could add a little more parking on the other side. But I think instead of doing that, why don't we remove some of this and leave some grass? And we have the lights here. We could add lights if you want. We have some lights, I think, down in here. So you can add a few more lights like that. Let's see, benches. Yeah, we could even add a little bit of picnic benches so they can sit out and enjoy a meal. You can add, I think, a barbecue. Let's see if we can find the barbecue. I think it's in vanilla and it's in props. Maybe it's in here. Let's take it off. There we go. I think down in here I saw a barbecue. Here it is. And we'll just add it to the side here. And you also have like different things. You could put hedges up. So if you wanted to put a line of hedges to block off like in here, make it a little more private, you could do that. Let's see, what else could we do? So they have vents for the top. So we could do that if you wanted. You could put, you know, you could add anything to the buildings. You really can't delete much off of these buildings, as you can see. Some of them you can, but others you can't. You could put a billboard on it. You could do just most anything. You could add a skylight or a rooftop window, you know, maybe up in the middle here, like that. What else could we do? We could do a fence if you want a fence. Let's see. We could do a fence around the back. Let's see. We'll turn off snapping. And maybe what we'll do is we'll just put the fence right across here, like that. And maybe across the parking lot here, like that. So you can make your own unique way of doing things. Now, if you want people to kind of hang out over here, you can add these little hangout areas and people will hang out. I think it looks pretty good. You could add a tree, maybe just one or two trees, little trees. Let's see if we could add a little tree. Maybe one right here. Like that. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. All right, so what we're going to do next is we're going to just save it with a picture and a picture and a picture. And then we're going to go up here. We're just going to save the asset. And I'll just name it My Fire. Okay, so make sure you change the photos. You do want the photos to match what you made, and click save. All right, so now that you did that, we're gonna quit and I'll be back in my city to show you the difference between the base game and the one you just made. All right, so here we are in my city of Lachlan, and let's go ahead and put in the two firehouses, the original and the new one. Let's delete some of these trees. There we go. All right, so let's come over to this side. I think we have a little more room. So if we go to fire, we have the original one, which is this one right here. And if you go down to the end, you'll see right here, it says My Fire. So let's find a spot that'll fit. And now you can see the difference. Now this does have a little bit of whatever going on, but for a fire station, it's kind of weird. It's got a lot of stuff going on here with, it almost looks like a industrial space, but yeah, I don't think you need all that. So anyway, I think this looks a little bit friendlier and it's got a little place to hang out. And we also have a place to add paths now. So we could take a path from any one of these and just take it and bring it down. It's got a hangout spot there. We can bring a path there. We can angle it. Got people parking in there, as you can see. Let's just check it out. So they aren't hanging out really, but they will probably hang out and do whatever they're doing. But anyway, as you can see, people are walking through, they're using the cars, they're walking through the fence, you know, I mean, normal Sim stuff. That's pretty much what Sims do. But as you can see, it does look a lot nicer than the one that we get with the base game. And it's just, I think, more functional. You could add the front door. I think it works with the front door. If we click on it, you could change the station, the trucks. So we can do that. We could do the large fire engine. So anyway, as you can see, it works just fine. The fire engine did go out. I'm not sure where he went, but he went somewhere. Wait, that might be... No, that's a bendy bus. Okay. So anyway, I just wanted to let you know that it does work and it works well. So if you like my content and you like more instructional or tutorial kind of things, I am no professional when it comes to this. I just want to put it out there. I'm just learning myself. So I'm just getting to know how to do these things on my own. And you can see people are hanging out. Look at that. That's pretty cool. There goes the fire engines. So yeah, I'm still learning myself. But as I learn, I just want people to know that it's nothing to be afraid of. And you're going to have a lot of nice custom assets in your own city. So if you like what you see, like, subscribe, comment, and share. And next time, we'll do another asset editor. I'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye.